Healthcare workers are being recruited to test the controversial drug hydroxychloroquine. Touted by President Trump as a COVID treatment, Melbourne researchers are investigating once and for all if it actually works. Medical reporter Emily Rice with the story.
During the pandemic, one drug has dominated the headlines.
Hydroxychloroquine.
Hydroxychloroquine could be one of the biggest game changers in medical history.
Hydroxychloroquine dene ka man banaya hai.
Now scientists at Melbourne's Walter and Eliza Hall Institute are putting the medication to the test on the front line.
To safely assess whether the drug hydroxychloroquine can protect Australian healthcare professionals from COVID-19.
The researchers are recruiting more than 600 hospital workers to take the drug daily. Professor Mark Pellegrini stresses the pills are not being scrutinised as a COVID cure, but as a potential prophylaxis, a medicinal guard against catching coronavirus in the first place.
It might still have substantial merit in preventing people becoming sick with COVID-19 if given prior to them being exposed to the virus.
The drug gained worldwide attention in May when President Trump revealed he was dosing up on it.
Hydroxychloroquine.
I'm taking it, hydroxychloroquine. Right now, yeah. Because I think it's good. I've heard a lot of good stories.
While hydroxychloroquine has hit the headlines because of COVID, it's certainly not a new drug. It's been used for decades to prevent malaria and treat inflammatory diseases like lupus. And when administered for these ailments, it is relatively safe.
Other Australian disease experts say it is worthwhile determining once and for all if the controversial pharmaceutical works, but they have doubts.
Drug development is hard. It's not easy, and it'll be a while before we can find something that will be effective.
Healthcare workers keen to volunteer in the trial can apply online.
It's really important that Australia does this study. We're leading the world in many aspects of doing COVID-19 research.
Emily Rice, Nine News.